Hi everyone, this is Mix from Sneaks and Ball PH, and today we have a quick look and unboxing on the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Zebra. The Yeezy line from Adidas has definitely been one of the most hyped sneaker lines of all time. And it's actually quite amazing that we even got an Adidas and Kanye West collaboration, because Kanye West did first collaborate with Nike in 2007. Nike and Kanye West did start their partnership in 2007, and it was pretty much off to a good start because of all the Air Yeezys that were pretty much sold out everywhere and super duper limited. However, in 2013, Nike and Kanye West didn't really see eye to eye anymore because Kanye West had some demands and Nike wasn't willing to fulfill them. This is why in December of 2013, Kanye West moved to Adidas. Then in 2015, Adidas released the Yeezy Boost 350, and Kanye West and Adidas have never looked back since. The hype train was pretty much rolling with the Yeezy Boost 350 V1. Then in 2016, they released the V2, and this just took it to another stratosphere. Every single Yeezy Boost 350 V1 and V2 release would end up selling out instantly, and with this Zebra colorway, it's pretty much no different. The Zebra colorway of the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 first debuted in 2017, and it pretty much became one of the most popular colorways of the 350 V2. It is definitely one of the must-haves for anyone who really loves Yeezys and really likes hype sneaker fashion. And in the 2020 release of the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Zebra, it pretty much is just as popular as ever. It did pretty much sell out right away on the Adidas website. However, I feel like Adidas did have quite a few more pairs than they usually do, because most of the people that I knew that wanted the shoe were able to get them. It still did sell out pretty quick, so not everyone who wanted a pair was able to get one, but I think that since there were a lot more pairs to go around, a good number of people were actually able to cop. Then with that out of the way, let's get into the unboxing. So for the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Zebra, it comes in your standard 350 box. So you have this giant 350 text here on the top, and then you also have Boost in really large font as well here on the front. And then here you have Yeezy Boost 350, as well as made by Adidas. Then here on the back, you have that same detail, but then you have your sizing and colorway information, as well as the price. Then now time to take a peek at the V2 Zebras. So you have this sort of style of box wherein it's like a drawer. So you pull it out, and just a little bit of paper. And wow, that's really, really white. So here you have it, guys. This is the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Zebra. So just taking both shoes out of the box, here you have your right shoe. And man, that's a very, very white outsole. And then just putting this aside, some more paper. Then here you have your left shoe. Then just fixing the box up a bit. Weird sound. Then here you have it, guys. This is the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Zebra. Then just a few quick tech specs on the Yeezy Boost 350 V2. For the traction, you have a very milky white outsole, as in this is one of the whitest outsoles I've ever seen. This is the kind of outsole that will get dirty from just your initial step, because wow, that's just look at it. Then for the traction pattern itself, it does have this sort of netted looking design, and it just has pretty much thick ridges, and this will sort of work because, like, as I said, it's just a casual shoe, so it'll pretty much work just fine. But then here on the heel, there is a triangular cutout on the outsole, and this exposes the cushion. Then for the cushion on the 350 V2, you have a full-length Boost midsole that's pretty much encased all the way around with this rubber. When the Yeezy Boost 350s first released and I saw this whole rubber cage that's around the Boost, I thought that it wouldn't be as comfortable because this could really subdue the Boost feeling. However, now that I've tried them on foot, it's super duper comfy. Like, you get that full Boost experience, and it's just an amazing feeling. It's pretty comparable to what you feel on the Ultra Boost, and I think it might actually be even softer. Aside from the Boost that they used on the 350 V2s being really soft, another thing that makes you really feel that soft and cushiony feeling is the fact that the insole is pretty much crap, because this insole is just paper thin. Like, Adidas, what the hell is this insole? But the benefit to that is the 350 V2s actually have a very soft strobel board, and it actually has a lot of cutouts as well, so you can pretty much, you know, when you take out the insole, you can really feel the boost underneath your foot. Then for the materials of the shoe, the 350 V2 has an entirely prime knit upper. Then here on the back, you do have this nylon pull tab, as well as these very thick rope laces. Then inside the shoe, you do have a little bit of neoprene padding here at the back, and it is really smooth and really soft. However, aside from that neoprene here at the heel, you don't really have anything else on the inside of the shoe, so you pretty much just get that raw prime knit feeling, and it feels amazing. It really wraps around your foot nicely, and it just feels like a really comfortable sweater. Then for fit and sizing, I did go through to size, and the fit was a bit weird because it was a little bit long, but it was pretty tight. Since this is a casual shoe, I understand why a lot of people recommend to go up half a size, because you know, if you go to your true size, it does feel quite snug. And for a casual shoe, you kind of just want it to fit a little bit loosely, because you know, what's the point of constricting your foot if you're just walking around and chilling? So what I would recommend is to go up half a size if you have a normal foot or a wide foot, but if you have a relatively narrower foot, I think you can go through the size. Then for the aesthetic details on the shoe, on the outsole you do have that really milky white rubber, and I'm just amazed at just how white this translucent rubber is. Like, I just feel like this can get dirty just by me looking at it. Then you also have that milky white rubber encasing the Boost midsole. Then for the upper, you do have that signature zebra pattern. So you have interwoven strands of black and white prime knit all throughout the upper. It does give it a pretty funky look, and you can actually see each of the black strands and the white strands just pretty much interlacing with each other. Then you have that white pull tab here at the back in the dotted black line. You also have your white rope laces, as well as this white strip here on the lateral side. And this has the signature design piece of the shoe, which is a reverse SPLY-350, which is in red. Then the shoe also has minimal branding. So here on the outsole, you just have Boost written on the heel. Then you don't really have any Adidas branding anywhere on the outside of the shoe. Instead, what you have is these three stripes on the inner side of the heel. And then lastly, you have that Adidas and Yeezy branding on the insole. So this has kind of been the trend for a while now, where you don't really have a lot of branding on your shoe. And in some ways, I do appreciate that. Then for the overall aesthetics, I'm gonna have to be honest with all of you, but I've never been a fan of the Yeezys. And this holds true whether it's the 350s, the 350 V2s, the 380s, the 700s, you know, it doesn't really make much of a difference. However, of course, I understand that a lot of people love the shoe because, like I said, it pretty much sells out in every colorway that they release. But I really can't see myself wearing this shoe. So I don't know, I think it's just this whole streamlined sock look on the upper, as well as that very exaggerated and wide midsole. And I'm also not a fan of all those ridges that are here on the rubber that cases the Boost. I don't know, it just really doesn't sit well with me. And lastly, I also don't like how the toe looks, because it's just like a super pointed toe. Because I don't know about you, but this doesn't look like how a foot should be, and it just kind of reminds me of ballet shoes. But you know, that's just my opinion, so don't hate on me for hating on the Yeezys. I know a lot of people really like this shoe and really love this colorway in particular. So if you really love the Yeezy Boost 350 V2s and you really love this colorway, then I'm really happy for you, and you know, you can love what you love. But for me in particular, I would just give this a hard pass. However, if it is any consolation, out of all of the Yeezys, I think that the Yeezy Boost 350 V2s look the best. Or how do I phrase this? It's the one that looks the least bad, if that makes any sense. But I would definitely trade these Yeezys in for some basketball shoes or basketball retros any day. Then for the price on the Yeezy Boost 350 V2s, it does retail for 13,000 pesos or $220. The 350 V2 is just like any other Yeezy, and it's pretty expensive. So if you were to ask me personally if it was worth it at 13,000 pesos, I would probably say no. Because for sure, it is very comfortable. So when I tried it on, that prime knit was just super soft and super nice on foot. And you also had that really comfortable Boost midsole. But in my opinion, for 4,000 pesos less, or around $50, you would get yourself a pair of Ultra Boosts, and that's pretty comfortable. And that does have a really nice prime knit upper as well. And in my opinion, the Ultra Boost is a lot more versatile, because it is a sort of athleisure look, so you can pretty much wear it to the gym as well as walking around. But I do know a lot of people that really love the Yeezys and would pretty much die to get a pair of Zebras. So if you're one of the people that really love this shoe, it's pretty much sold out. So you're gonna have to go on the resale market. On the resale market, these fetch a price of around 18,000 pesos. However, if you are looking for a pair, you just have to really be diligent in looking for the best price. Because, you know, even though the average price is around 18,000, I think you can find some pairs for 17 or 16,000. So there you have it, guys. That was my quick look and unboxing on the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Zebra. I know it's not my cup of tea, but I do understand that a lot of people love this shoe. So to each his own. So if you liked the video, please make sure to leave a thumbs up down below. Then if you have any comments, questions, or any suggestions for any future videos, please feel free to leave them in the comment section down below as well. Then please also sound off in the comment section down below if you love the V2 Zebras, or if you're like me and you would just pass on these altogether. Then if you haven't already yet, please make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon for notifications. It would help us out a lot. Here at Sneaks and Ball, PH.